Please stand and join our opening hymn to Jesus Christ, our Sovereign King.
Jesus Christ, our Sovereign King, In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you. Brothers and sisters, as we gather this day in the Cathedral Basilica to celebrate the Mass, the ordination of two of our brothers, let us first pause and acknowledge our sins, preparing ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Lord our God, who in governing your people make use of the ministry of priests, grant a persevering obedience to your will to these deacons of your church, whom you graciously chose today for the office of the priesthood, so that by their ministry and life they may gain glory for you in Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah.
The word of the Lord came to me thus. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you. Ah, Lord God, I said, I know not how to speak. I am too young. Say not, I am too young. To whomever I send you, you shall go. Whatever I command you, you shall speak. Have no fear before them, because I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Then the Lord extended his hand and touched my mouth, saying, see, I place my words in your mouth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lectura de la carta a los hebreos. Hermanos, todos somos sacerdotes, un hombre escogido entre los hombres y está constituido para intervenir en favor de ellos ante Dios, para ofrecer dones y sacrificios por los pecados. Él puede comprender a los ignorantes y extraviados, ya que él mismo está envuelto en debilidades. Por eso, así como debe ofrecer sacrificios por los pecados del pueblo, debe ofrecerlos también por los suyos propios. Nadie puede apropiarse ese honor, sino solo aquel que es llamado por Dios, como lo fue Aarón. De igual manera, Cristo no se confirió a sí mismo la dignidad de sumo sacerdote. Se la otorgó a quien le había dicho: tú eres mi hijo, yo te he engendrado hoy. O como dice otro pasaje de la Escritura: tú eres sacerdote eterno como Melquisedec. Precisamente por eso, Cristo durante su vida mortal ofreció oraciones y súplicas, con poderoso clamor y lágrimas, aquel que podía librarlo de la muerte y fue escuchado por su piedad. A pesar de que era el Hijo, aprendió a obedecer padeciendo y llegado a su perfección, se convirtió en la causa de la salvación eterna para todos los que les obedecen y fue proclamado por Dios sumo sacerdote como Melquisedec. Palabra de Dios.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and prayed, saying, Holy Father, I revealed your name to those whom you gave me out of the world. They belong to you, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. I gave them your word, and the world hated them, because they do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. I do not ask that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, so I sent them into the world. And I consecrate myself for them, so that they also may be consecrated in truth.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let those to be ordained priests come forward. Reverend Mr. Gerson Parra Mesa. Reverend Mr. Christopher Michael Rubie.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain these men, our brothers, to the responsibility of the priesthood.
Do you know them to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people, and upon the recommendation of those responsible, I testify that they have been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and our Savior Jesus Christ, we choose these are brothers for the order of the priesthood.
Thanks be to God.
We have just heard in the gospel, Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and prayed saying, Holy Father, I revealed your name to those you gave me out of the world. They belonged to you and you gave them to me and they have kept your word. Sanctify them in the truth. We listen to Jesus praying for the holiness of his disciples. Sanctifying has to do with consecrating and dedicating something to Almighty God, which we see in the first reading when God says to Jeremiah, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. Prophet to the nations, I appointed you. It is the invitation given today to you, Christopher, and to you, Gerson, on this your ordination day, that you are called to be beloved sons. Of the various identities that define a priest, that of beloved son is the most fundamental. It is an identity that priests share with the rest of the Christian faithful. St. Paul has taught us in Galatians 4, verse 6, that we are sons of God because God has poured the Spirit of his Son into us, enabling us to address God as Abba, Father. Priestly mediation requires that a priest have a vital relationship both with God and with the people he is serving. Like every Christian, an ordained priest is a son of the Father in Christ. Christ, the beloved Son, graced with the Holy Spirit that gives him the heart of the Father in the mind of Christ. His sonship is essential to his priestly ministry, since united with Christ, our high priest, an ordained priest is a mediator between God and the people that he serves. Several years ago, Cardinal Bernardin of Chicago said, "As a priest, we are not dispensable functionaries. We are bridges to the very mystery of God and healers of souls. It is at the Eucharistic table that you will find the strength to live out your call, a call to holiness, and the strength for your pastoral ministry. It is also here that you will fall in love with Christ in an ever deeper growing way. But remember, you are not called primarily to do, but rather to be. This is difficult to understand at a time in the church where there is a shortage of priests. But sealed with a priestly character, which is real, indelible, and spiritual, you are invited to identify with Christ in a new and deeper way. People will come to you because they know that you taste and see the goodness of the Lord." I remember a wonderful old Jesuit priest that I was privileged to work with and later to live with. He was also my spiritual director. After successfully fulfilling positions of great influence with the Jesuits, he spent the last 20 years of his priestly life working with the poor. Each month, I would watch as he gave his salary away to those who were in great need. In a retreat conference, he said, "I met a priest once. I asked him what that meant, and he said, 'We never quit working on arriving, but by virtue of ordination, are empowered to act in persona Christi, which demands that with God's grace, we spend a lifetime developing our Christ likeness. This is challenging in a world so satisfied with itself. As parish priests, we are called to live among the people, proclaiming the word and celebrating the sacraments, in this day and age, especially penance and Eucharist, and informing community in the parishes where you will be assigned. The model here is always Christ the Good Shepherd. For the Good Shepherd is one who lays down his life, and today this demands from the priest a profound sense of faith and the gift of discernment, developed through your prayer and meditation. As shepherds, the priest is called to imitate the virtues and attitudes of Christ, reflecting always Christ's love. Jesus knows his own and is known by them. This model demands that we resist any temptation to secularize the priesthood or to live a watered-down priestly identity. In the last few years, we have learned a painful lesson how quickly contemporary society abandons a priest who has given in to temptation. The priest today must be someone with a shepherd's care. In his prayer and sacrifice, the priest, like Christ, intercedes with God on behalf of the human family. The shepherd must be totally dedicated to the flock and be prepared to suffer in its defense. In practical terms, the only priest who will always prove necessary to people is the priest who is conscious of the full meaning of his priesthood, the priest who believes profoundly, who professes his faith with courage, who prays fervently, who teaches with deep conviction, who serves, who puts into practice in his own life the program of the Beatitudes, who knows how to love disinterestedly, who is close to everyone, especially to those who are most in need. As we look at the challenges that confront the church and the priesthood today, I recommend that you keep Luke chapter 18, verse 1 in mind. Pray continually and never lose heart. This will allow you to meditate on the infinite goodness and love of Christ, who called you each by name and said to you, "Follow me." Each day we are called to give to the Lord an account of our service and our zeal and our fidelity, for we are Christ's servants. At the same time, we must give an account of our negligence and sins, of our timidity, of our lack of faith, and our hope. It does not escape the church, says the pastoral constitution on the church in the modern world, how great a distance lies between the message she offers and the human weakness of those to whom the gospel is entrusted. Devotion to the Blessed Mother must shape your priestly lives, and you can spend a lifetime prayerfully applying the words, "I come to do your will." Mary's perfect obedience will demonstrate how to live out your gentle obedience in sacrificial union with Christ, and her purity, the way you express your own grateful love to God and to those you serve. May the way you live out your priesthood find you someday among the blazing splendor of the saints. Dear sons, before you enter the order of the priesthood, you must declare before the people your intention to undertake this office. You resolve, with the help of the Holy Spirit, to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyteral rank as worthy fellow workers with the order of bishops in caring for the Lord's flock. You resolve to exercise the ministry of the word worthily and wisely, preaching the gospel and teaching the Catholic faith. You resolve to celebrate faithfully and reverently, in accord with the Church's tradition, the mysteries of Christ, especially the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation, for the glory of God and the sanctification of the Christian people. You resolve to implore with us God's mercy upon the people entrusted to your care, by observing the command to pray without ceasing. You resolve to be united more closely every day to Christ, the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him to consecrate yourselves to God for the salvation of all. Do you promise respect and obedience to me and to my successors?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Do you promise respect and obedience to me and to my successors?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. My dear people, let us pray that God, the all-powerful Father, will pour out abundantly the gifts of heaven on these his servants whom he has chosen for the office of priest.
Please kneel during the litany of the saints.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, Michael,
pray for us.
Holy angels of God,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Peter and Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Andrew, Saint John,
pray for us.
Saint Mary Magdalene,
pray for us.
Saint Stephen,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Antioch,
pray for us.
Saint Lawrence,
pray for us.
Saint Perpetua and Saint Felicity,
pray for us.
Saint Agnes and Saint Cecilia,
pray for us.
Saint Gregory,
pray for us.
Saint Augustine,
pray for us.
Saint Athanasius,
pray for us.
Saint Basil,
pray for us.
Saint Martin,
pray for us.
Saint Benedict,
pray for us.
Saint Francis and Saint Dominic,
pray for us.
Saint Francis Xavier,
pray for us.
Saint John Vianney,
pray for us.
Saint Catherine of Siena,
pray for us.
Saint Teresa of Jesus,
pray for us.
Saint Alphonsus Liguori,
pray for us.
Blessed Oscar Romero,
pray for us.
Saint Rose Philippine Duchenne,
pray for us.
Saint Vincent de Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Louis, King of France,
pray for us.
All holy men and women,
pray for us.
Lord, be merciful.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from all evil.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from every sin.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from everlasting death.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by your incarnation.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by your death and resurrection.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
be merciful to us sinners.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Govern and protect your holy church.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Keep the Pope and all the ordained in faithful service to your church.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless these chosen men.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless and sanctify these chosen men.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
bless, sanctify, and consecrate these chosen men.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bring all peoples together in peace and true harmony.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Comfort with your mercy the troubled and the afflicted.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Strengthen all of us and keep us in your holy service.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Jesus, Son of the living God.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Hear us, we beseech you, Lord our God, and pour out on these servants of yours the blessing of the Holy Spirit and the power of priestly grace, that those whom in the sight of your mercy we offer to be consecrated may be surrounded by your rich and unfailing gifts. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please stand. Please be seated. Please stand.
Draw near, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, author of human dignity. It is you who apportion all graces. Through you everything progresses. Through you all things are made to stand firm. To form a priestly people, you appoint ministers of Christ your Son by the power of the Holy Spirit, arranging them in different orders. Already in the earlier covenant, offices arose established through mystical rites when you set Moses and Aaron over your people to govern and sanctify them. You chose men next in rank and dignity to accompany them and assist them in their task. So too in the desert, you implanted the spirit of Moses in the hearts of 70 wise men, and with their help he ruled your people with greater ease. So also upon the sons of Aaron, you poured an abundant share of their father's plenty, that the number of the priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, who is apostle and high priest of our confession. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself to you as a spotless victim, and he made his apostles, consecrated in the truth, sharers in his mission. You provide them also with companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation throughout the whole world. And now we beseech you, Lord, in our weakness, to grant to these helpers that we need to exercise the priesthood that comes from the apostles. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, to these your servants the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within them the spirit of holiness. May they henceforth possess this office, which comes from you, O God, and is next in rank to the office of bishop. And by the example of their manner of life, may they instill right conduct. May they be worthy co-workers with our order, so that by their preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts and reach them to the ends of the world. Together with us, may they be faithful stewards of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed in the waters of rebirth and nourished from your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled and the sick raised up. May they be joined with us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to their care and for all the world. And so may the full number of the nations gathered together in Christ be transformed into your one people and made perfect in your kingdom through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Please be seated.
The Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and with power, guard and preserve you so that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifices to God. The Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who have willed that your priests should minister at the holy altar and serve your people, grant by the power of this sacrifice, we pray, that the labors of your servants may constantly please you, and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son High Priest of the new and eternal covenant. And by your wondrous design, we're pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with the royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with your word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard and unite and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, my assisting bishops, the Order of Bishops, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you alone, for them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all those who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you also for these your servants, whom you have been pleased to raise to the order of priesthood, and in your mercy keep safe your gifts in them, so that what they have received by divine commission, they may fulfill by divine assistance. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve these offerings in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable to you, that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, in all who sleep in Christ, a place for refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alice, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Amid us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of Christ's peace.
Peace be with you.
We told me speak of time.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Oh,
Let us rise and pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to your priests and to all your servants, that united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Before the solemn blessing, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you, Father Mason, and the members of your staff, faculty, and board of trustees who are here today. Thank you for preparing these men on their way to the altar. A special appreciation to each of the families for sharing your sons with the church, and for all of your friends who are gathered here, Christopher and Gerson, we pray in thanksgiving for the way they've been praying for you over the years and also helping you along. My brother priests and deacons, thank you for being with us today. I can assure you, Gerson and Christopher, that you're entering a great presbyterate, and I know that you'll be good members. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who founded the church and guides her still, protect you constantly with his grace, that you may faithfully discharge the duties of the priesthood.
Amen.
May he make you servants and witnesses in the world to divine charity and truth, and faithful ministers of reconciliation.
Amen.
May he make you true shepherds to provide the living bread and word of life to the faithful, that they may continue to grow in the unity of the body of Christ.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Three.